Have you ever spent hours color grading only to export and realize your footage looks totally washed out or nothing like what you saw on the timeline? I've been there too, and I've spent dozens of hours finding the solution. In this video, I'm going to walk you through every deliver page setting in DaVinci Resolve that actually matters, so your final export looks just as good as your final grade. By the end, you'll be exporting with confidence and without guessing. Let's jump right in. Hi, I'm European filmmaker, and in just 5 years, I went from zero to paid music video DP and colorist. And I'm here to hand you the tricks I wish I had on day one. Today, we are diving into the mythical deliver page in DaVinci Resolve, so your exports finally look as good as your grade. First, I want to address the elephant in the room, gamma shift issue while exporting on a Mac. Let me tell you, I've been in this maze for over a year. For those grading on Mac computers, this should be a well-known issue. But before we get into the solution, let's break down what causes this. Well, if you are exporting from Resolve on a Mac, your video might look perfect in the timeline, but totally washed out in QuickTime, Preview, or even YouTube. macOS uses something called Color Sync, and it likes to mess with Rec. 709 footage. Basically, it applies its own gamma curve to your export, whether you ask for it or not. On top of that, if you don't tag your export properly, things go sideways fast. If you leave the gamma on the default Rec. 709 scene, macOS thinks it's something else entirely. That's why it plays back with lower contrast and looks desaturated. So, what we can do about it? I'm sure you've heard of something called Rec. 709A. First, let's clear something up. Rec. 709A isn't some new color space. It doesn't change your actual image. It just adds a simple tag for macOS to correctly read the gamma curve. Without that tag, macOS assumes a gamma of 1.96, which is why your footage looks flat in QuickTime. But when you tag your export as Rec. 709A, QuickTime plays it back properly. To fix this, I recommend switching to non-managed DaVinci YRGB and handling your color pipeline with CSTs, as I always teach on this channel. This gives you full control. What this setup does is uses Rec. 709A for monitoring while the CST dictates what's actually baked into the file. And that's exactly what we want in this case. So, let's set it up the right way. First, open Preferences and check the box that says Use Mac Display Color Profiles for Viewers. This setting tells Resolve to use your Mac's display profile in the timeline view. Now, open Project Settings and let's configure the color management. For color science, select DaVinci YRGB. For timeline, or as I like to say, your working color space, I recommend DaVinci Wide Gamut Intermediate, which is perfect for color grading. But if you prefer another color space, that's totally fine. For the output color space, or in other words, your display color space, select Rec. 709A. Now, let's set up a quick note tree in the color page. I'll keep it simple for this demonstration. First, add a CST or Color Space Transform plugin to Node 1. Here, we need to convert our footage into our working color space, which is DaVinci Wide Gamut Intermediate. In my case, I'm using footage from Fuji camera shot in F-Log 2. So for input color space, I'll choose Rec. 2020 and for gamma, I'll select F-Log 2. For output color space, choose DaVinci Wide Gamut Intermediate. Leave the middle node for basic adjustments like exposure or white balance. Then, in the final node, add another CST, set the input color space to DaVinci Wide Gamut Intermediate, and for the output, choose Rec. 709. For gamma, it's up to you. But if you are grading for web delivery like YouTube, I'd recommend gamma 2.2. There you have it. A quick workaround if you are grading on Mac displays. Of course, for a professional approach, it's always better to use a dedicated and calibrated grading monitor alongside an I/O device, which lets you bypass all the GPU processing. Now, let's dive into the Deliver page and take a look at what all these settings are about. I want you to stay till the end, and we'll craft the perfect preset for your exports together. But before we continue, I want you to introduce you to my LUT pack, which I crafted specifically for the DaVinci Wide Gamut color space. It includes 7 subtle handmade LUTs that keep your skin tones in the right spot and your mid exposure untouched. They add a touch of filmic contrast and split toning. If you'd like to check them out, I left a link in the description. Alright, now let's break down all these mysterious settings in the Deliver page. First thing, in the video tab, we need to choose a format. The default is QuickTime, which is perfect in most cases. The only time I change this is when I'm exporting reels for Instagram. This setting is the container it holds your codec. Some platforms don't like the MOV container, for example Instagram sometimes doesn't play audio if I export in QuickTime. Other than that, QuickTime is usually the best option. Now for the codec, it depends on where you're delivering to. For YouTube or any other web service, I'd stick with H.264 or even better, H.265, which is more optimized in compression and can output 10-bit color instead of 8. That's the way to avoid color banding issues that often show up after export. If you are delivering a final export to a client for TV broadcast or you just want the highest quality possible, Apple ProRes is your best bet. Just keep in mind that the file sizes are about 10 times bigger than H.264 or H.265, but if you need the best, that's the way to go. Of course, as you can see, there are 6 options to choose from. So you might ask, which one should I pick? Let's break them down. Proxy is only useful for editing, not final exports. File sizes are the smallest, but the quality is limited. Great for faster editing. LT stands for light. Weighs about 30% less than regular ProRes. Good enough for general edits or even YouTube. 422 is optimal for broadcast. File sizes are larger, but quality is excellent. HQ is the highest in the 422 family, ideal for high-end masters. The last two are designed for heavy grading or VFX work. These are the only two in the ProRes family that support alpha channels, which makes them ideal for overlays or graphics. In short, for web, I use H.265. For high-end delivery or client work, I use ProRes 422. For this video, let's stick with H.265. And take a look at the other settings we can tweak. For timeline resolution and frame rate, I just stick with whatever the timeline is set to, and that's all the buzz. In the quality tab, I like to change from automatic to restrict to, and for 4K, I set it to 60 megabits per second and 30 megabits for HD. For encoding profile, your best choice is main 10. These profiles represent different bitrates and chroma subsampling. Main is for 8-bit footage, main 10 is for 10-bit 420, and the last one is for a higher-end delivery, not always supported on web platforms. Now, most people overlook the next setting, multi-pass encode. It optimizes bitrate allocation in your final file, improving both quality and compression efficiency, at the cost of longer export times. So, if you are not in a rush, it's a no-brainer, turn it on. Frame reordering helps with better compression, but in rare cases it can cause visual artifacts. If you don't see any issues, leave it on. Finally, jump to the Advanced tab and check 2 important boxes, Force Sizing and Force Debayer to highest quality. These ensure that your footage is decoded and rendered at maximum quality during export. Always check both. So, there you have it, a perfect preset for YouTube or any other web service. Of course, feel free to adjust it to your needs and don't forget to save it as a preset for a faster workflow. Just click the three dots and select Save as New Preset. And if you are using DaVinci Resolve 20, you can now add a thumbnail image and even include your preset in Quick Export menu, which makes things even better. And if you want to improve your color grading skills, check out this next video.